According to a report from videocards.com, it looks like Nvidia is gearing up to launch their new GPU, the RTX 4070 Ti. This new card is expected to be priced at $799, which is a bit of a discount from the original price that Nvidia had planned for it. So what's the deal with this new card? Well, it looks like it's essentially a rebranded version of the RTX 4080 with 12GB of RAM. The original plan was to sell the RTX 4080 for $899, but after facing some intense criticism, Nvidia decided to lower the price and bring it back as RTX 4070 Ti. One thing to note is that the $799 price point is the suggested retail price for partner cards. This means that Nvidia itself is not releasing a Founders Edition version of RTX 4070 Ti. Unfortunately, this also means that if history is any indication, it may be difficult to find this card at the $799 price point. Typically, when a new GPU is released, the board partners that manufacture and sell the card, they tend to run out of stock pretty quickly. And when they do have the card in stock, they often try to sell their own souped up versions of the card that has been overclocked for extra performance. Now, these overclocked versions usually come with a higher price tag, so it's possible that you may have to pay more than the MSRP of $799. Now, let's take a look at this leaked presentation from Nvidia. So this shows that RTX 4070 Ti will have 40 shader teraflops, 93 RT teraflops, and 642 Tensor teraflops. Now this GPU will feature a full AD104 die with 7680 CUDA cores. It will be equipped with 12GB of GDDR6X memory and it will be rated for 285 TDP. Now the smart among you would have already figured out that these are the same exact specs that the cancelled RTX 4080, the 12GB model of this card, it was also boasting the same exact specs. Okay, so let's take a look at the 3DMark leaked results that we have. So here you can see RTX 4070 Ti, this is the baseline, so 100%. Now, RTX 4090 is significantly faster, 82% faster in Speedway, 81% faster in Port Royal. RTX 4080 is also significantly faster, 30%, 24%, and at higher resolution, you can see it's about 20 to 25% faster. Now, interestingly, RTX 4070 Ti is comparable to 3090 Ti, but it is losing in some and gaining in some. So, for example, Speedway and Port Royal, 3090 Ti is faster, 7% faster in Speedway and 3% faster in Port Royal. But then when you bump up the resolution, when you go to 1440p, 4070 Ti takes the lead. So 7% faster in Time Spy 1440p, neck to neck when you have 4K resolution for Time Spy Extreme Test. But for 1440p resolution, Firestrike Extreme Test, 4070 Ti takes a 4% lead here. And then in 4K resolution, 3090 Ti comes out ahead. So this is interesting. In most of these cases, I would say that 3090 Ti has a slight advantage over 4070 Ti. And I would be really interested to see how Nvidia spins this, because I'm sure they will come out and say that, hey, our 4070 Ti card is faster than 3090 Ti card. At least in this benchmark, that doesn't look like the case. Seems like 3090 is still slightly faster than 4070 Ti. But I'm more interested in looking at a comparison with RX 7900 XTX and RX 7900 XT. RX 7900 XTX is actually 4% faster, 59 versus 55. Same story with Port Royal. AMD flagship card is 4% faster and its smaller cousin is almost neck to neck with the RTX 4070 Ti. Now with Time Spy 1440p, when we bump up the resolution here, interestingly AMD card takes up the lead now. So 7900 XTX is 81% and even the smaller cousin 7900 XT is coming out ahead. So for higher resolution, seems like AMD cards are actually performing better than RTX 4070 Ti. And the same is true for Time Spy Extreme 4K, where you actually see AMD cards taking significant leads. So 76% and 65%. Both these cards are ahead of 4070 Ti. Same story with Firestrike Extreme 1440p edition, 84% and 73% compared to 61% here. And same story with Firestrike Ultra 4K. Next, let's talk about the RTX 4070 and RTX 4060 Ti, which I think will be particularly appealing to mainstream gamers and content creators. While we don't have any specifics on the pricing yet, I would speculate that RTX 4070 will likely be sold for around $699 and the RTX 4060 Ti will be priced at around $599. Now, it's worth noting that these prices are definitely higher than what we saw for the equivalent GPUs from the previous generation of Nvidia products. However, I'm hopeful that the performance of these new cards will justify their higher price tags. It better be. Overall, it looks like RTX 4070 Ti, RTX 4070, and RTX 4060 Ti are shaping up to be interesting new GPUs from Nvidia in the year 2023. While RTX 4070 Ti is is a rebranded version of the 12GB RTX 4080. At least it will be selling at a slightly lower price point. RTX 4070 and RTX 4060 Ti, on the other hand, seem to be great options for those who are looking for a GPU but who don't want to break their bank. They offer a solid balance of performance and affordability, and I'm sure they will be popular among gamers and content creators. By the way, if you are interested in learning more about the video editing and content creation performance of the RTX 4090, 4080 and AMD RX 7900 XTX, you might want to check out these two videos over here. In them, I compare and contrast how these cards perform in Adobe Premiere Pro, DaVinci Resolve and Blender. So go ahead and watch these videos, and I will see you guys over there. Bye.